Thousands of Army Corps personnel spent Saturday in preparation mode, planning and testing equipment for Sunday's spillway operation.
They're out today inspecting the cranes and all the machinery to make sure it's working too.
Sunday marks the first time in 5 years and just the 11th time in history that the Mississippi River has been high enough to warrant spillway relief. The plan, to carefully pluck needles from the spillway bays, opening the floodgates from the rising river and releasing massive amounts of water into Lake Pontchartrain.
And so they have the cranes that go across and they lift up the needles one by one. It's very labor intensive, takes about 15 to 20 minutes to pull all the needles out of a bay.
The move is a last resort effort to avoid potentially catastrophic flooding in New Orleans.
As the river rises and starts to crest, more bays will be opened, and then as it starts to recede, the bays will slowly be closed in order to keep that from exceeding 1.25 million cubic feet per second.
That's the set point for the river, moving now at over 9 million gallons per second. And once the river reaches 17 feet, official flood stage here in New Orleans, the spillway will maintain that level until the high water event is over. 6 miles of land separate the Bonnie Carey spillway from Lake Pontchartrain, where all of this river water is headed. Now, the spillway has never been operated this early in the year in January, so there's not a lot known about what the river water will do to the lake water. Now, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers does have an environmental team monitoring the lake, looking for any adverse effects while the spillway is open. Reporting from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers District Headquarters in New Orleans, Jennifer Crockett, WDSU News.